Ladies and gentlemen, foolishness is an office. Somebody has to occupy it. It is the choices of mortals that decides who occupies it. Whether we like it or not, somebody must be foolish for wisdom to continue to have value. Who that person is, we don't know. Time will define. But foolishness is not an insult. Stupidity are not insults. They are states of existence. They are status. It means that there is a set of behavior that conforms to a definition. As you cannot call a carpenter a surgeon or call a poet a lawyer, so you cannot call a wise person a foolish person or call a foolish person a wise person. Essentially, Paul said, "Oh foolish Galatians." He didn't confess positive and say, "Oh wise Galatians." He called them foolish Galatians because they were acting in a way that is consistent with the meaning of foolishness. And some people are foolish. Some of our friends are foolish. Even us, we might be foolish, such that we need to come to a state to begin to realize that our wisdom is sacrosanct. We are not intelligent people. We have the wisdom of God. That's superior to intelligence. That's the difference between academics, education, and revelation. Education has done well in the world. Academics has done well in the world. Education is ruling the world. Revelation is the next big thing that will rule the world. And you and I are the ones with access to that revelation. Disabled should not employ able. By meaning, able should employ disabled. When disabled is employing able, then something is wrong about our perception of able or disabled. Something is wrong. Our definition is not thorough yet, because what we see is not all that can be seen. What is seen and what we understand is created by our experience and our history. No knowledge is the lowest type of knowledge. You must add wisdom to non-knowledge to create innovation. Listen, whether it's Stevie Wonder, he never wondered in his life. I'm sure you know. More time on air, the joy of many generations. And I've spoken to Kobams one-on-one. He said he's not even conscious that he's blind. Everything works. He has resources. He goes where people cannot go. He flies business class anywhere. He does stuff that people with eyes cannot see. When Ray Charles, you know Ray Charles, the American legend, if he's in this room and he's here, if a cockroach is moving at that end, he will hear the sound. And he will go there and touch that cockroach and bring it out for everybody. From here, you will hear the sound. Guess what? You see too clearly to hear that sound. So what he has lost, what he has lost to sight, he has gained by an heightened sense of perception. Therefore, disability is an unpopular type of ability. That's why when they went to Jesus and they said, "Who sinned? This guy or his mother and this," he said, "It's unto the glory of God." You don't understand. You are short-sighted. There's no limitation in that popular definition of disability. When we take, we are fearfully and wonderfully made, and we reduce it to physical beauty, we make a big mistake and a very prejudiced view of God. When you limit and fearfully made to beauty, what of those who are born crippled? What of those who are born without hands? They shouldn't use that scripture. When there is no scripture that is of private interpretation, and every promise in the Bible is available for every Christian, that means that you are fearfully and wonderfully made. It's not for physical beauty or how you stand, your statistics, your cup, your body, your back, and how you stretch or how you don't stretch. It has nothing to do with that. Essentially, it's about the beauty from the inside. The idea that that deposit is in every human being, that everyone born of a woman is born with enough focus, enough clarity to do the impossible and to win at every level, regardless of his physical construct. Your physical construct has nothing to do with your inner construct. And when you understand that, you operate life and regulate it inside out, not outside in. That's why the Bible said, whatever is outside cannot define a man. Jesus said, what defiles a man is from inside out. And he listed all the things that defile a man. And the last one on the list was foolishness. And he said, all these evil things come out from the man.